Welcome to DCEB Surya Beta YouTube channel. 10th class online classes, social studies English medium. This is Vadde Chandrasekhar, working as school assistant at GHS CBS Madira in Khammam district. Today we are going to learn second part of 20th lesson in 10th class social studies, social movements in our times. So already we have completed first part. Today we are going to continue the second part. In the second part, the subtopics are globalization, marginalized people and environmental movements, Bhopal gas disaster related movements and environmental movements. So these are the subtopics of today's class. So we will go to the class. Learning outcomes. The student explains the impact of globalization on underprivileged and poor people. So here, the student can explain the impact of globalization on poor and underprivileged people and different sections of the people. The student analyzes the Bhopal gas tragedy. What are the reasons behind Bhopal gas tragedy? He can explain, and he can explain the consequences of the Bhopal gas tragedy. The student gives reasons for the movement started against Narmada River Dam. The student appreciates the efforts of local people in protection of Silent Valley. Why the people started movement against the silent dams constructed on the rivers, across rivers in Silent Valley. Okay, the student explains the importance of different strategies used in the social movements. So these are the learning outcomes of today's class. So here, globalization, marginalized people and environmental movements. So what is globalization? So globalization means the economic and political changes happening worldwide since 1990, which go by the name of globalization. Globalization is also known as neoliberalism. So here, globalization showed deep impact on the lives of underprivileged and poor people. So the impact of globalization mainly on the poor people only. So the lives of poor people and underprivileged people affects more because of globalization. Particularly, an unorganized and industrial workers have been the worst hit. At the same time, these people, they don't have access to formal education and adequate nutrition and health. So because they didn't have adequate nutritional facilities and health facilities, they don't have access to better paying jobs or to legal or other constitutional remedies. Okay, mainly tribal and marginal farmers have also been threatened by commercial farming, mining corporations and dam projects, etc. So the tribal and marginal farmers, the farmers who are having very low land, okay, these people, they threatened by commercial farming, which was taken by the corporates, and mining corporations, which are taking huge lands, more area of lands for mining purpose, at the same time dam projects also. Rare resources in rural areas like minerals, rare plants or animals and water, like these are all resources under threat. Okay, ousting of the farming and people from their traditional areas. So the people who are living in forest areas, the people who are living in rural areas, who are living near very forest areas, they are their traditional native places are taken by the corporates or mining corporations or dam projects. So resulted dispersion of communities, the communities of different sections, they dispersed from their native lands and they have to give their land to the corporates. Destruction of tribal cultures. So because of the dispersion of the communities, the cultures of those people disturbed because of this dispersion. Depletion of natural resources. So the, in the name of development, the government is giving huge land, thousands of acres of land to the corporates and mining corporations. Because of these activities, slowly the natural resources are depleting day by day. It leads to the environmental problems, that leads to environmental movements. Okay, so this is about globalization and marginalized people and environmental movements. So here, one is an important environmental movement which was started in Europe, particularly in America. So against American underwater nuclear tests near Alaska in 1971. So America wants to conduct underwater nuclear tests near Alaska Sea in 1971. Some of the volunteers, they wanted to stop these tests, and they traveled on a ship named as Greenpeace near to the nuclear test. So based on the name of ship, this movement named as Greenpeace movement. So the headquarters of the Greenpeace movement is located in Amsterdam, which is a capital city of Holland or Netherlands. Okay, Greenpeace movement is a non-governmental organization. It spread over 40 countries now. At present, it spread over 40 countries, and it is going, it is taking activities in all countries. So because why these environmental movements are starting? So what is the importance of environmental movement? Why they are taking these movements? So because of the pollution, because of the globalization, because of the industrialization, day by day the pollution in the atmosphere is increasing. So because of the pollution in the atmosphere, ozone layer which is there in stratosphere is depleting day by day. So if ozone layer depletes in future, the ultraviolet rays which are coming from sun, they reach directly to the earth surface. If the ultraviolet rays reach directly to the earth surface, it may cause for the skin cancers and so many health disorders. Okay, so because of the pollution, ozone layer is depleting day by day. So because of the temperatures increasing on the earth surface, it causes the melting of polar ice caps. The polar regions, North Pole and South Pole, they covered with the full of ice. So if the temperatures increases, the polar ice caps may melt, and the melted water joins with the oceans. So it leads to the increase in the sea level. If the sea level increases 1 meter, so many coastal areas in all the continents, mainly the coastal areas, may submerge in the ocean water. That leads to the destruction of the coastal areas. So global warming will cause erratic rainfall and crop failure also. So because of the global warming, so many climatic changes are occurring. Because of the climatic changes, erratic rainfall may appear. At the same time, because of the uneven rainfall, crops may failure. Okay, because of the climatic changes, these affect the agriculture of many countries, particularly the poor countries or underdeveloped countries or developing countries, which are depending mainly on agriculture. They may affect more than the other developed countries. Okay, so the main aim of the Greenpeace movement is ensuring the ability of the earth to nurture life in all its diversity. Once again, I am reading, the aim of Greenpeace movement is ensuring the ability of the earth to nature life in all its diversity. Okay, so rejuvenate the nature, quality of the environment, they want to rejuvenate. So developed an idea of sustainable development. So because of the Greenpeace movement, they developed a idea that is sustainable development. So what is sustainable development? Development is different from sustainable development. Sustainable development means, so by using the available natural resources, we have to develop at present, and we should leave some resources for the future generations. That is nothing but sustainable development. Okay, we should not use all the resources, available resources at present only, but we should leave some resources for the future generations. That is sustainable development. So like that, we have to plan for future generations also. So here is a Greenpeace, the ship. It is a Greenpeace ship. With this Greenpeace ship, the volunteers reached to the Alaska, where the underwater nuclear test happened. So here Amchitka you see the white area is Alaska. The red dot area is a place where the American government is conducting underwater nuclear tests. So they traveled from Alaska to Omsk with this Greenpeace ship. That's why this movement named as the Greenpeace movement. Okay, next, another great tragedy in the Indian history, that is a Bhopal gas disaster. Okay, it is a great tragedy happened in Bhopal in 1984. Thousands of people died and so many thousands of people still they are suffering with this tragedy. A poisonous gas leaked from Union Carbide factory, after named as Dow Company. Okay, Union Carbide factory. So thousands of people died and many more still suffering from its ill effects. So because of the gas leakage from Bhopal Union Carbide factory, so many people they died and so many thousands of people still they are suffering, still they are facing so many problems caused by the gas leakage. So these people, they have four demands in front of the governments or a Union Carbide factory. Okay, they want proper medical treatment of the victims. So what they want? Proper medical treatment of the victims. So second one, adequate compensation for them based on international standards. Then why they are asking compensation based on international standards? Because the Union Carbide company is a multinational company. It is an American based company. So that it is a multinational company. That's why they are asking compensation on the basis of international standards. Fixing criminal responsibility for the disaster in the management of the company. Okay, here the victims, they want the company should take the responsibility. So the government should file a criminal case on this management. So steps to prevent such disasters in the future. So again, they are asking the government should take some preventive measures or steps to control this type of disasters in future, because now we experienced the loss of this disaster. That's why we should not repeat this type of disasters in the future. That's why they want government should prevent this disaster. In reality, lot of amount spent for treatment. So the victims, the people who are suffering from this gas leakage, they are spending more amounts on treatment, still suffering from its effects. But compensation is not paid as per international standards. The company trying to escape from the paying compensation on the basis of international standards, they paid on the basis of Indian standards only. Social boycott of Dow company as a sponsor of London Olympics. After this Bhopal gas disaster, Dow company signed an agreement as a sponsor of London Olympics. But so many people, so many intellectuals and environmental lovers, they signed a petition against an unethical alliance with the Dow company in London Olympics. So when this type of disasters happen in any country, the multinational companies, they are trying to escape to pay the compensation simply by using the laws which are there, the loopholes which are there in the laws in that countries. So even though they are multinational companies, but they are not ready to pay compensation on the basis of international standards, but they are trying to pay the compensation on the basis of local laws regarding that particular country. So then they are trying to get more profits than the taking safety measures. So here you can observe in the red circle, the Bhopal is there. Bhopal is the capital city of Madhya Pradesh. So this tragedy happened in Bhopal, is the capital city of Madhya Pradesh. So here in the second picture, you can observe the commemorated Bhopal gas tragedy being commemorated. Here they are paying the tributes to the victims of the Bhopal tragedy. Then environmental movements. So the movements which want to protect environment, natural environment. So for that, some people started environmental movements. So start in our country too in 1970s, grassroots movements for the natural protection of natural protection of natural forest, example CIPCO movement. So in earlier classes we have discussed about CIPCO movement. When the contractor wants to cut the trees, the local people, they surround the trees and they protect trees by cutting from the cutting. Okay, that is nothing but CIPCO movement. So building of the large multi-purpose dams was an integral part of India's planned development from 1950s. From independent onwards, we are following, from 1950s onwards, we are following five-year plans. Okay, so in five-year plans, in India's planned development, we are following first construction of multi-purpose dams for the development of agriculture, which gives more food grains to the people. So when we are constructing multi-purpose dams, they need thousands of acres of land. At that time, so many villages, they have to evacuate from the native places. Otherwise, they may submerge in the backwater of the multi-purpose dams, like Nagarjuna Sagar Dam, Bakra Nangal Dam, Hirakud Dam. So these are the major multi-purpose dams in our India. Okay. So we have advantages at the same time disadvantages with these dams. Advantages of dams, these are useful for huge amount of water storage. Okay, with these dams we can store more water in rainy season and we can use for the other seasons. At the same time, the water is available for the vast tracts of agriculture. So with the water which stored in these projects, we can supply for the agriculture. At the same time, these projects are helpful for the generation of electricity, which is sufficient for our needs. At the same time, these projects are too useful for the control of floods. At the same time, droughts also. Okay, so if we can store more water in rainy season, we can use in other seasons. It helps to control the droughts. In rainy season, these are helpful for the control of floods. Okay, so at the same time, disadvantage is also there. So much of forest land, so much of villages, they may submerge in the backwater of reservoir. And thousands of agriculture land, animals, and forest animals, they may submerge in the backwater. Okay, these are the disadvantages. At the same time, some of the traditional people who are living in that area, they have to evacuate and they may lose their old traditional cultures. Okay. At the same time, thousands of acres of fertile land or fertile fields may submerge and people displaced to construct dams. Okay, these are the disadvantages of multi-purpose dams. That's why so many people, they are starting movements against construction of large dams or multi-purpose dams. So instead of construction of large dams, they want small dams which won't displace the people and which won't harmful for the traditional cultures. Okay, like that the people are starting environmental movements. So delays in construction leads to the rise in the cost of dam. So when they are constructing large dams, so much of delay is going on in the construction, it leads to the rise in the cost of dam. They seldom irrigated the amount of land initially proposed to be irrigated, produced as much as electricity as projected. But at the time of planning of the dam, they showed so much of more electricity may generate, but in reality, that is not possible. At the same time, the actual storage is differ from the engineer's estimation. So when the planning time, the engineers estimated more water storage, but in actual, it is not possible. So store up to actual estimation. Okay. So another environmental movement, which is going in Madhya Pradesh, Narmada Bachav Andolan. So it is against the construction of dams on Narmada River. Okay, so the government planned to construct a series of large and small dams on Narmada River. So people demanded for fair compensation. So the people who are victim of Narmada River dams, they demanded for a fair compensation according to the market value. So proper rehabilitation with the land in return. So they want who lost land under these dams, they want land in another area along with the rehabilitation. At the same time, afforestation to compensate loss of forest. When so much of forest submerged in the these dams, the people are the victims of the dams. They demand for the afforestation to compensate loss of forest in another areas. But in the people realized two things with the help of these incidents. One is no adequate land to compensate for the loss. So it is not possible to compensate land with land in another area. Okay, because no adequate land to compensate for the loss. Problem is not the question compensation, but one of a faulty notion of development. So in a mostly developing countries and underdeveloped countries, the notion of the development, they are thinking like if we construct large dams, we will develop easily like that. They are thinking, but it's a faulty notion of development. Because of the construction of large dams, so many lakhs of people they are displacing from their native land, and so many thousands of fertile land submerged in the dam water, and so many thousands of forest area is also submerged in the dams. Okay, development which was based on unsustainable use of natural resources. Now only we have discussed about the sustainable development. So when we are going and taking up developmental activities, we should think about the sustainable development only. But we are thinking about unsustainable use of natural resources. While we are using natural resources, we are thinking about the present condition and present needs only. But we are not thinking the future needs, and we are not leaving any resources for the future generations. If we complete all the resources, what about the future generations? So while we are taking up developmental activities, we should think in a sustainable way. Then only we can get a good development. This is made only unskilled labor without enhancing the quality of their lives in any way. So we are thinking an unsustainable use of natural resources that leads to only preparation of unskilled labor without enhancing the quality of their lives in any way. So always we should try to improve or enhance the quality of the lives of the people in through developmental activities. But our developmental activities are trying to prepare unskilled labor without enhancing the quality of the people. Okay, here you can observe the pictures. Narmada Bachao Andolan, again is the dams which are going to construct on Narmada River. So they are conducting so many Andolans, Narmada Bachao Andolan, protest in Narmada Valley against displacement. So these are the people, they have to leave their own lands or native places. So that's why they are conducting protest. The leaders of this movement decided to oppose the construction of dams on Narmada River. They started Narmada Bachao Andolan, NBA. So Sardar Sarovar project was expected to build with the World Bank money. So on Narmada River, across the Narmada River, Sardar Sarovar project was expected to build with the money borrowed from World Bank. But after intense protests, mobilization of the people, marches conducted by the victims, hunger fast, and an international campaign, finally, World Bank decided to withdraw its funding to the Sardar Sarovar project. Okay, so the people, local people, they conducted so many different forms of movements or protests. So intense protests, mobilization, marches, hunger fast, and international campaign. So different forms of protests they used to stop the construction of Sardar Sarovar project. It succeeded in forcing everyone to rethink about the utility of large construction projects. So the Narmada Bachao Andolan, they succeeded in forcing everyone to rethink about the utility of large construction projects. So the governments and the people, the engineers, the intellectuals, everyone should rethink in developmental way, in a sustainable way. It forced governments to consider giving adequate and respectable compensation for such development induces displacement of people. So for the local people, the victims of the dams, they are sacrificing their lives, their native land, native villagers, and their traditional culture they are sacrificing for the development of the country. So the governments also should give adequate and respectable compensation for their sacrifice, but it is not happening in most situations. That's why the movements are going on nowadays also. The NBA movement combines in itself many strands, like movements of indigenous people, movement against neoliberal policies, struggle of farmers for their lands. Okay, so the Narmada Bachao Andolan, it combines other movements also, like indigenous people who are the victims of the land dam, and movements against neoliberal policies. The governments are giving importance to the neoliberal policies of corporates, and struggle from farmers for their lands. So like that, so many stands are, different stands are there in NBA, Narmada Bachao Andolan. So here you can observe the Narmada River Basin, hydroelectric projects in Narmada River Basin. So here the black strips are there. These are all proposed hydroelectric projects on Narmada River Basin. Okay. So here, to know the status of environment in India, CSE was founded by Anil Agarwal in 1980 to study environmental and developmental issues in India and build awareness about these problems. It began with the publication of its famous series, Citizens Report of State of India's Environment, in 1982. And these reports have become authoritative references on various environmental issues. Okay, CSE is the authoritative agency to study about the India's environmental and developmental issues. So here, another movement which was started in Kerala in Western Ghats, Silent Valley Movement, between 1973 to 85. So when the Kerala government proposed to build a dam across two rivers flowing through Silent Valley in Western Ghats in Kerala, the people, many educated people, realized that it is a very disastrous for the rare species of animals and plants that lived in that valley. These include one of the most endangered primate species, the lion-tailed macaw, a kind of monkey you can observe in the picture. So it's a one kind of monkey. It's a primitive species which is there in the Silent Valley only. If the government constructed dams across the rivers in Silent Valley, these are all primitive species may disappear from the area. Gradually, a major movement developed against the dams and in favor of saving the Silent Valley. So people across the state were mobilized by Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, KSSP, an organization working for popularization of science and learning among common people. So Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, they mobilized the people all over the state against the dams which are going to construct on across the rivers in Silent Valley. Okay, finally, they filed a case in Kerala High Court. Kerala High Court ordered stopping of clear felling. In view of these severe protests, the government finally decided to give up the dam project, and they have taken a good decision, that is conversion of Silent Valley into a national park in 1985. Okay. So this is also one of the major environmental movement which is happened in Kerala, Silent Valley Movement. So here, what the Silent Valley Movement happened in Kerala. It is located in Western Ghats. Okay, so here is a important species of monkey, that is one kind of monkey, lion-tailed macaw, primitive species. So who led the protest or environment movement or Silent Valley Movement? Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad. Finally, the government convert this Silent Valley into national park in 1985. Children, are you following me? So these are all bits, soul studies bits. So please remember. So here, the leader of Narmada Bachao Andolan, Medha Patkar. Okay, so a interview with Medha Patkar. So the following is an interview with Medha Patkar, one of the leaders of NBA, talking about the organization in 2010. So here, Is there any point in continuing the struggle now that Gujarat government has done exactly what it wants to? So is the answer of Medha Patkar. The struggle cannot be over unless the goals are attained. Okay. At the same time, the development, the progressive and land-based, if it appears that it has not been able to guarantee land to those who lost their livelihood, the environmental measures have not been compiled with that to raise the height of the dam, disregarding various conditions made in the clearances and the policy promises in unjust. Okay, the struggle will also have to continue to show to the world that whatever little was achieved by submerging the habitats of nature-based communities and incurring huge social, environmental and financial costs is not going to really needy people of the Kutch, but to corporates and the big cities in Gujarat. The NBA demands a change in this pattern. The struggle against displacement, destruction and disparity is also to continue with alternative development paradigm and reconstructive work as is being carried out not only in the Narmada Valley but across country. So children, observe the interview of the Medha Patkar. She proposed alternative developmental plans also, and she clearly talking about the plan why they are conducting this Narmada Bachao Andolan against the displacement, against the destruction and the disparity is also to continue. So she is telling about the Narmada Bachao Andolan. At the same time, she is proposing alternative development paradigm and reconstructive work as being carried out not only in the Narmada Valley but also across the country. So the government should rethink about that destructive plans, developmental plans. Okay, they have to think about alternative plans also, which gives less destruction, less displacement, okay, less harmful for the people. So children, up to now we have discussed about the environmental and social movements. So now I recapitulate the lesson. The economic and political changes happening worldwide in 1990s, which go by the name of globalization or neoliberalism. Okay, so the economic and political changes happening worldwide in 1990s is called as globalization or neoliberalism. So because of the globalization or neoliberalism, tribals and poor peasants and workers impacted more than other sections of the people. Tribals and marginal farmers threatened by commercial farming, mining corporations and dam projects. So why these people only threatened by these commercial farming, mining, dam projects means they are the victims of displacement. They are the victims of commercial farming. They are the victims of mining corporations. They have to leave their own native land and they have to disturb their traditional cultures. Okay, so against the pollution which is created which is harmful for the environment, Greenpeace movement started against American underwater nuclear tests. Okay, so Greenpeace is a non-governmental organization which has a headquarter in Amsterdam, is the capital city of Holland, also known as the Netherlands. So they started a movement against American underwater nuclear test near Alaska Sea, okay, in 1971. So Bhopal tragedy was a great tragedy, happened in 1984. Because of this tragedy, thousands of people died and thousands of people still they are suffering because of this Bhopal tragedy, because of the gas, poisonous gas leakage from Union Carbide Company, after named as Dow Company. Okay, so this is a major tragedy which has happened in our India. So the government should rethink about this type of tragedies. Movements against dams on Narmada River led by Medha Patkar. So one of the leader of Narmada Bachao Andolan is Medha Patkar. They conducted movements against the dams which are going to conduct on Narmada River, across Narmada River, which destruct which displace thousands or lakhs of people and which submerge lakhs of forest area. Okay, finally, World Bank withdrew its funding to Sardar Sarovar project on Narmada River after continuous tireless movements of Narmada Bachao Andolan. Because of Silent Valley movement, Kerala government give up the dam project and convert the Silent Valley into a national park. So Silent Valley is located in Western Ghats in Kerala. So the Kerala government is proposed to construct two dam across two rivers in Silent Valley. At that time, the intellectuals and the Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, they conducted a protest against the dam. Finally, the Kerala government gave up the dam and convert that Silent Valley into a national park. Okay, children, now we have completed today's class. Now I will giving some evaluation purpose questions. First one is write about the impact of globalization on different sections of people. So why did volunteers decide to stop underwater nuclear tests? Okay, what are the main demands of Bhopal tragedy victims? So what are the demands? So you have to write the demands. Analyze the key features of Narmada Bachao Andolan. So what are the important salient features of Narmada Bachao Andolan? So here people began to realize that the problem was not the question of compensation or rehabilitation, but one of a faulty notion of development. So analyze this statement and write your opinion. Okay, children, so try to read this statement, analyze in your way and write your own opinion on this statement. Okay, children, write answers to these questions and show to your teacher in your school. Okay, thank you, one and all.